गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम भूपेश कोहली, फिजिकल एजुकेशन टीचर। टुडे सेशन फॉर क्लास प्लस वन स्टूडेंट्स, यूनिट 6, फिजिकल एक्टिविटी एंड लीडरशिप ट्रेनिंग। फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, क्वालिटीज ऑफ अ गुड लीडर। व्हाट इज द क्वालिटी ऑफ अ लीडर? इज अ फर्स्ट क्वालिटी, पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ अ लीडर। Personality of a leader is the inner and outer personality of a good leader should be impressive. By inner personality, we mean the qualities of self-confidence, knowledge, experience, impartial behavior, etc. Outer personality means that he should wear neat and clean clothes and should behave lovingly with everybody. Second, quality of a good leader, intelligent and knowledgeable. A good leader should be intelligent and knowledgeable also. He should have confidence on his knowledge and intelligence. A good leader is always intelligent and knowledgeable. He has to take many decisions while playing, which depend on his knowledge about the game. The third quality of a good leader is punctual. A good leader should be a punctual. He should respect the value of time. He should beforehand prepare his daily schedule so that he reach everywhere in time. Next is decisive. Decision making. A good leader should have the ability to taking instant decision on the basis of available knowledge. He therefore depends upon his experience and knowledge for his. Next is broad-minded. A good leader should always be prepared to learn something new. He should have the intellect to evaluate his plan and changes. Players are always ready to improve their level of performance. They are also ready to learn new techniques. Next quality is discipline and honest. A good leader should always be a role of model for others. He should never give a wrong decision. He should also not to take the side of a wrong person. The indisciplined players are punished. Thus, the players always try to keep themselves in discipline. Next is courageous and confident. Seventh quality, a good leader should have full confidence in his abilities. He should have the courage to face the truth. He should also be ready to accept the improvement and shortcomings. Next, eighth is unbiased. A good leader should be unbiased. He should not be partial to anybody. He should treat everybody equally. An unbiased leader respects everybody. A good leader is also unbiased. He praises only the good game. Next is a good orator. Words are of a great importance for men. A good leader should be a good orator as well. He can create a new enthusiasm in messages through his words. The words of praise act as stimulant for the player. Thus, all players praise each other and raise the confidence of other. Many more qualities of a good leader, like a idol of followers, good moral character, determination, sense of humor, and a good orator. Idol of followers. These are the many more qualities of a good leader. The next topic is role of leader. What is the role of leader? General functions of a leader remain same, but specific functions vary from group to group. The importance of a leadership in the field can be seen in the functions which he has to perform. These some following the role of leader in this field. First is provide a vision. Providing a vision for the entire team is the single most important role of a leader. Team members cannot be expected to participate in a common effort if they don't know the goals. When team members know the vision and goals, they are more focused and understand how their individual role helps to drive the success of the business. Now, second role of a leader is structure of the situation. Now, leader should be absolutely clear about what they want to accomplish. Leader's function is to structure the situation for the group members. He interprets the actual situation by clarifying the doubts. He has to observe every situation mentally to help the group to reach the goal smoothly. Third role of a leader is control group behavior. Now, leader involves a great deal to controlling exactly what happens in the team. Leader has to strive hard to prevent certain types of individual differences which are against the best interests of team. He has to enforce the rules to maintain the discipline in the team. Next, fourth role of a leader is plan of the group. The leader has to decide the ways and means by which the group achieve its goal. He has to make short as well as long plans, and it's up to him to determine which one is executed and which one is confided to only few. While making plan, he should have every aspect in his mind. He continually looks for ways to make it easier for his team members to do their jobs. Next is execution of plan. This is an important role of a leader. Execution is an important factor in achieving the aim and objectives of the group. So it is leader's responsibility to see that the plan is executed in the right way. Because the success or failure of a plan depends upon the way you execute it. These are some role of our leaders. Many more role of a leader is like evaluate the progress, leader as a representative, and many more. Now, next topic is creating leaders through physical education. How to create leaders through physical education? Which strategies to apply to create leaders through physical education? Now, first, strategy is appointing a student as a leader of a mass exercise. A student can be appointed as a leader while conducting mass exercise programs. This will help him or her to have confidence, and it will help him become future leader. Now, second is appointing a student as a team captain. A student can be made a captain of a team. In this way, he will know how to control all members in his team. He will be able to understand better that a team is more important than individual. Next is allowing a student to officiate in intramural competition. A student can be assigned duties for preparation of grounds. He can help of their ground staff and assist them in creating better facilities for games and sports. It will help him in getting more discipline, and he will know how to help others. Physical education teachers can entrust the students to officiate intramural competitions. Intramural competition is a intra-school competition. Competition in school, houses, you know, own institute students can participate in these tournaments. These are intramural tournaments. Now, allowing a student to officiate intramural competition, physical education teachers can trust the students to officiate intramural competitions with his, firstly, the students will be able to know the pressures of conducting such a program, and they will also know how to fare with all teams. Next is appointing a student as member as well as in charges for various school committees. The physical education teacher can allow a student to take on a variety of roles with the school committee formed for conducting intramurals. In this, students can be an in charge or a member of various committees formed. This will allow the student to practice leadership. A student who is in charge of the ground and equipment committee will have full responsibility for clean and right equipment, and he will be answerable for any problem. Lastly, assigning duties for preparation of ground. I also explain this point. Assign the duties for preparation of grounds. He can help the ground staff and assist them. It will help him getting more discipline, and he will know how help others. Now today's session is over. Next session we start the next topics. There are adventure sports. Goodbye and have a nice day.